It actually takes more than one shot to train a model.
Hello world, it's Siraj, and welcome to Fresh Machine Learning. This course is all about making bleeding-edge machine learning accessible to developers. The field is moving faster than Steve Ballmer at a developer conference.
Developers, developers, developers!
We're going to learn to apply some of the latest machine learning techniques to practical examples that you can integrate into your own apps. Neural networks have been around since the 50s, but we've just never had as much data and computing power as we do now. We call it deep learning these days, and it deserves the press it's gotten, but so many articles claim it replicates the human brain. Some even make it sound like if we give a deep neural net enough data and compute, it'll suddenly become self-aware. The brain is indeed a neural network, but do we really learn the way a deep neural net does? Well, let's think about it. In order for a deep neural net to learn to, say, recognize an image of a banana, you first have to feed it hundreds of thousands of banana images. But think about the way you and I learn. If I were to show you an image of a banana for the first time, you'd probably be able to recognize a novel banana instantly, even if it was a different shape or color. We humans don't seem to need thousands of examples just to generalize, just a few. And we learn richer representations than machines do as well. We can use the concepts we learn in other ways, like creating new examples. If we could create an algorithm to do this, to learn concepts with few examples, wouldn't that be incredible? It would further democratize the field so that not just the big companies like Google and Amazon with huge private internal datasets are able to train their models, but anyone can. So is there an algorithm that does this? Well, there was a recent paper that came out called Human-Level Concept Learning Through Probabilistic Program Induction. The authors said, let's build a model capable of what's called one-shot learning. One-shot learning is a type of ML that learns an object category after just one or a few examples.
Oh!
They use something called Bayesian Program Learning, or BPL, to do this. Bayesian refers to Bayes' theorem, which attempts to use simple stochastic programs to represent concepts. The word stochastic, referring to the theory of probability, is what Bayes' theorem loosely revolves around. So by using simple stochastic programs, or probability algorithms, BPL can represent concepts. BPL builds these simple stochastic programs compositionally, from parts, subparts, and spatial relations. All these things exist in a hierarchy of knowledge, which the machine has gained through little experience. So they trained it on a dataset of handwriting characters, and it was able to recognize characters with a better error rate than deep learning or even humans. So does that mean that BPL is the way to go? Well, it does have its flaws. It lacks explicit knowledge of certain things like parallel lines, symmetry, and connections between ends of strokes and other strokes. And the learning isn't really transferable to other things, so it's not better than deep learning in every way. A few months later though, DeepMind challenged the paper by releasing their own called One-Shot Learning with Memory-Augmented Neural Networks. The basic idea they had was that deep learning is very data intensive, but perhaps there's a way to build a deep neural net that only needs a few examples to learn. Deep learning without the huge data sets. So they built what's called a memory augmented neural network. A MANN has two parts, a controller, which is either a feed forward neural net or LSTM neural net, and an external memory module. The controller interacts with the external memory module with a number of read write heads. It's capable of long term storage via slow updates of the weights and short term storage via the external memory module. They fed it a few examples of handwritten characters and continuously trained it thousands of times on just those examples. And guess what? It outperformed humans as well. So they proved that one shot learning can be accomplished by using a neural network architecture, which is pretty dope. So there are lots of methodologies to implement one-shot learning, and in this episode, we're going to implement our own. We're going to build a one-shot handwritten character classifier in Python using the SciPy library, so
hold on to your butts.
We got to import our dependencies first. We're going to want three libraries, NumPy, SciPy, and Copy. Once we have those, we can define two variables, the number of runs we want to complete and a reference var for where we store our class label. Then in our main method, we can create an array of the size of runs, which is 20. We'll use this array to store all of our classification error rates, one every run. Then we'll write a for loop to train our algorithm 20 times. For each run, we'll run a classification function, which will attempt to classify a small sample set of images and store the error rate in the array. Then we'll print out the error rate to terminal, and when we are done with all of our runs, we'll go ahead and get the mean error rate from the array and print it out as the last statement in terminal. So how does this classification step work? Before we answer that, we need to understand these two methods, load images points and modified Hausdorff distance. The load images points function loads an image file. In our case, this will be a character image. It then converts the image to an array and finds all the non-zero values, that is all of the inked pixels, and stores that in an array. Then it creates an array of all the coordinates of those pixels and returns that. The modified Hausdorff distance is a metric that computes the similarity between two images by comparing their pixel coordinate arrays. That comes from the loadImagesPoints function. It calculates the mean difference between both images and returns it. The last parameter of the classification function, cost, just notifies the function that small values from the modified Hausdorff distance mean more similar. Lastly, let's take a look at the classification function itself. In this function, we retrieve both our training and testing images and load their image point matrices into memory. Then we compute the cost matrix using the modified Hausdorff distance. After that, we compute the error rate and return it. That's all. We do this for every run and then average them all and get the average error rate, which isn't state-of-the-art like DeepMind or BPL, but it does make for a good baseline demo of one-shot learning. One-shot learning will only get more popular over time. Bunch of cool links down below. Check them out, and please subscribe for more ML videos. For now, I've got to go fix an index out of bounds error, so thanks for watching.